Do you want to develop this type of game in Power App using timer control? Hi, this is Krupali from KnowHow Academy. So let's start with me. For developing this type of game, we need to take a blank canvas app and let's design this four screen. First screen for start, click on start game, then challenge one, then challenge two screen, and the last screen is thank you screen. Okay, so let's design a first screen. Okay. I design the first screen. Let me take a new screen and design for the challenge one screen. So in that I need to take a header, then I need to display the message and then what challenge I am giving, and then I need to give a space. So let me design, and here I need to display the time, what time it is there. So let me quickly design this. Okay, so for that I need to take a timer apart from the text box and label. So let me add timer. Let me put it here. So timer has a property called duration. By default the duration of the timer is 1 minute, that is 60 seconds. So 60,000, that is 60 minutes. Okay, so I am setting a duration that is 7,000, that is 7 seconds. Okay, now apart from the duration, timer has a property called text, then whatever the name of that timer, then auto start, then what should be the end value of that. So what I need to do, I need to set some coding on that. Okay, so by right now I am setting the timer duration property. Just let me show you. Timer duration property is a 7000, then we will take a second screen, then third screen, and then we will come back to the screen and start coding. Okay, so let me take duplicate this screen. Okay, and here this is a typing challenge 2. Okay, so I have designed with the screen and the last screen that is remaining called a thank you screen. Okay, let me rename it, and here let me change the color and let me put the text. Okay. Now in last screen we are displaying what they have written in challenge 1 and what they have written in challenge 2. So let me take a label. The label for displaying what user has written. Okay, and we'll display the result like this: challenge one not completed. If it is completed, then we will display the result like that. Okay, so for that I need to take two label. So first label, okay, and the second label. Let me write something so I will not forget the result label. Okay, now what we will do in challenge one screen. Now in challenge one screen, we will set first the auto start property of the timer. So auto start property of the timer we will set to on. Okay, or Here, from here also you can start auto timer to true. Now let's see what happened when you start it auto timer 1. Now let's say when you run a screen, timer will start automatically. It will show up to 7. Why? Because we set the duration 7. So timer will start from the 1 second and it will increase by 1. Now whatever value of the timer is increasing, we want to display it here also. So what we can do, timer1.text. So whatever it is showing, we can display like that. Okay, so now say if it is increasing, here we are displaying the value. And then what we will do, we will write a code so that when a timer ends, that means when the duration of the timer will end, that is up to 7 seconds, so automatically it will redirect it to the next screen, that is challenge 2 screen. Okay, so for that what we need to do, so we need to click on the timer, and there is one property called timer end property. Okay, on timer start and on timer end. We don't want to do anything when the timer start, but we want to do navigation to the second screen when the timer end. So we need to write something that is on a timer end. So what we want to do, first of all we need to reset the timer value. And then we want to navigate to the screen 5_1. Okay, navigate screen 1, whatever. Okay, and then how we will do navigate. Okay, so this is the how screen will show, that is a screen transition. Okay, and let's see how it will work. Now see, automatically when the timer reach to 7 seconds, it will redirect it to the second screen. Okay, so same thing we can do it on the another screen, that is screen 5 on timer. Okay, we have written this, and on this timer we will set the 7000, that is timer duration, and on timer end again we will redirect it to the screen thank you screen. Okay, so on timer end, reset timer 2, and then we will redirect it to the next screen, that is screen thank you screen. Okay, and let's run and check it. We forget to set the auto start property to true. Okay, so let's save. So it is started, and then it will reach to the next screen. Okay, here your thank you screen will appear. Okay, let me just set here the value timer2.text. okay, we will set the property. Now what we will do here, now at the end we will checking whether the value whatever user has written in this text box, it match with that or not. If it is not matched, then we will display the result 1 or challenge 1 is not completed, and if it is matched, then we will display challenge 1 completed. Okay, so how we can do that? So first of all, on app start, there is on start, we will write one variable, that is global variable, which will contain the value. What value? Whatever the user has written in the text box. Okay, so set challenge 1 initially blank, and then set challenge 2 and initially it's blank, and complete the bracket. Now when timer navigate to the second screen, whatever user has written, we need to assign it into the challenge 1 variable. Okay, so how we can do that? So for that we will set the value, set challenge 1 equal to whatever user has written in the text box, so challenge 1.text. okay, so then it will navigate to the second screen. Now on the second challenge, on the timer end, what we want to do, we want to do the same thing but for the next variable. So set challenge 2, then txt challenge 2 dot text, okay, and we have written this. Now on the next screen, what we need to do, whatever user has written, we need to print that thing on that label. So what we will print here, challenge 1 value, whatever user has written, okay, and this is challenge 2 value. Okay, so let me just start the game, and here we forget to write a code that will navigate to this screen. Okay, let me save and run. Okay, so timer is started, and let's say here I have written hello, and then I am writing hi. Automatically after 7 seconds, whatever I have written in that text box, you can see that. But I don't need to write hi and hello, I need to write whatever challenge is given to me. And here on this screen visible property, we are resetting the value of the text box. So reset text 1, sorry, challenge 1, and here on this on visible property, I am resetting the value of challenge 2. Got it. Now on the second or you can say on the last screen, what I want to do, I want to check it whether the value of that thing, okay, whether the value of that label is equal to whatever user has written in this text box. Okay, so let me give the LBL challenge 1 name here on this, and on the second screen let me give this to LBL challenge 2. Okay, now on the last, on the text property, what I want to do, I want to match. So what I want to match, I want to match if the LBL challenge 1 dot text equal to challenge 1. Why? Because challenge 1 is a variable which contains the value whatever user has written, and then we write completed challenge 1 completed. Otherwise we will write challenge 1 not completed. Okay, and same for that text box. Okay, sorry, not text box, for the same label. So in label text property we will write, now this time instead of label 1 we are taking label 2 challenge, and then we are matching with the challenge 2, and then we have written challenge 2 completed and challenge 2 not completed. Okay, now let's check it. Okay, so both the challenge I am not able to complete, so it is displaying that you cannot complete the challenge. But when the challenge is not completed, what we want to do, we want to display that is in a red color, and if it is completed, then we want to display it in a green color. So how can we do that? So on a label there is one property called color property, and on that color property, what we want to do, we want to set the color either green or either red based on whatever value or whatever the challenge it is. So challenge 1 equal to label 1 dot challenge dot text, then if it is equal to that, then we want to set the color dot green, so it will display in a green color, sorry, dot green, and otherwise it will display in red color, so color dot red. Okay, and same for this also. So again we are setting the color property here. So if challenge 2 equal to label challenge 2 dot text, then color dot green, and otherwise color dot red. Now remember, when we are setting the color, we need to make sure that we are in the color property, and when we are setting the text value, so we should check it whether we are in a text property of that thing. Okay, so let me save and run it. Okay, so still I'm not able to type that much fast. Okay, so I'm not able to complete this challenge. Okay, now let me increase the timer duration so I can complete it at least. So let me take it to 10,000. Okay, then you will see that I can type it and you will see that message in a green color. Okay. Okay, so I'm able to complete in 8 seconds, and let me try this also. Oh, see, this challenge 1, I am able to complete, and challenge 2, I cannot complete. So, this way, you can develop this type of typing game using a timer control.
You may have a question that what type of other things we can do with the timer. So, let me tell you. Let's say if you are designing an online MCQ quiz for the user. So in that type of screen, or to developing this type of screen, you can use a timer which will display the question, and after some amount of time or amount of minute, question automatically question go to the next screen. And the second project you can develop is that, let's say you are playing a tic-tac game. And in that, if you are not able to play within some amount of time, so automatically your game will over. So I hope you understand how timer control works in Power App. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as a source of your IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. Do not feel hesitate to reach out to us. Stay curious and keep learning.